This is an East German AK74 bayonet, and I'm going to demonstrate the wire cutter and saw feature of this. The AK74 rifle is a follow-on to the AK47 rifle that came out in the year 1974. For wire cutting, the scabbard and the blade mate together like this, with the cutting done by this notch here. I'm going to demonstrate on three wires. Here I have a chunk of regular household electrical cord, and we'll see how that cuts. And I cut right through it nicely. Here we have some electrical household cable, commonly used for wiring up electrical outlets and the like. I'll just cut right through that. And as you can see, it just makes fast work of it. And finally, I have a heavy gauge grounding wire, and I'll try and cut through that. We'll see what happens. And that's pretty heavy stuff, and just went right through it. A word of caution here. Don't ever cut live electrical wires. You can end up real dead if you did that. To protect the soldier, the scabbard body and the bayonet handle are plastic. The metal on the handle is not electrically connected to the blade, as this meter will show. This shows the blade conducts, but the latch mechanism is not electrically connected to the blade. This will prevent the soldier from getting electrocuted if he's out in the field, say, cutting an electrical fence or an electrical wire. Here's a disadvantage of this bayonet. This is the belt mount. And it's designed to be unclipped from the scabbard, so the scabbard can be removed for wire cutting. Now this rattles. So when the soldier is running in the field, it will rattle like this. And this could tip off an enemy of the soldier's presence. To make the saw useful, the blade is mounted upside down from what you might expect. When the bayonet is attached to the rifle, the saw is at the bottom and the knife edge is up. So the barrel would go in here, and as you can see, the knife edge is now at the top and the saw is at the bottom. This is so that the full weight of the rifle and the soldier can be brought to bear on whatever is being cut with the saw. I will now demo the saw on this chunk of dowel. And we'll just see how good it can cut here. So as you can see, in short order, it's gone a fair bit into this dowel. And if I was to continue, it would eventually cut right through. Of course, if I had the full weight of myself with a rifle and I was ramming it through, it would cut a lot faster. And it would also tend to break whatever I was cutting, and it would go through even faster. This bayonet is a great collector's item, and I recommend you buy one if you get the chance.